lovely people. So today I have the BookTube newbie tag to share with y'all. You know, I figured I've already done a handful of videos. I might as well go back to the beginning and just formally introduce myself. So I have the questions all written down right here. Let's go ahead and just jump right in because I'm sure I'm just going to be very long-winded with all of my answers. The first question is, why did you start this channel? I think this is kind of twofold. I love YouTube. I have had a YouTube channel since pretty much its creation in 2008. I remember when the like circle, circle, dot, dot with the little Lego people and shoes and all those like classic YouTube videos first came out. I've pretty much been an avid watcher of YouTube ever since. I'm always on YouTube. I'm always watching different types of videos. I have in the past put up different types of videos. However, no community really I felt I meshed with, and there wasn't like a subgenre of YouTube that I was truly committed to and really just encompassed everything that is me up until when I found BookTube. So I stumbled across BookTube, I wanna say 2018-ish. So it was right before I went to BookCon for the first time. I just was fascinated and I just fell in love with all these people talking about books. I was like, this is something I could see myself doing. So here we are a couple years later, with a little push from some really great friends, I decided to finally take the plunge and just talk about my passions on the internet. So that's kind of the long answer as to why I started this channel. Question number two, what are some fun, unique things you can bring to BookTube? This question kind of had me stumped because I could definitely come on here and share some, you know, big ideas with you guys and make some big promises of the type of content that I want to create and the things that I want to share with you guys. But that's not really me. You know, I am me. I don't think I'm a terribly interesting person. It was difficult for me to come up with, you know, a cool answer for this. However, I did remember this quote, or rather an idea I heard from an author. And I tried to look it up before I started filming and I couldn't find it. So if anybody knows what I'm talking about, if you could just leave a comment and let me know. But this is something I read somewhere from some author. It was basically saying how young writers get really hung up and discouraged when they're trying to write their first novel because they feel like they can't come up with an original idea and they can't come up with, you know, a story that hasn't already been told. However, what they don't realize is the story has never been told through their perspective. I just think that that really encompasses my idea of why I'm here. I don't necessarily think I have some groundbreaking ideas or these extraordinarily creative content ideas that I want to share with you guys. I just have a love of books. And I want to share my opinions as well. Question number three, what are you most excited about with this new channel? I'm really excited to have consistency. So kind of what I alluded to before, I've made some content in the past, you can't find it, it's not online, don't try. But this is kind of the first time where I feel really committed to consistently putting out content and being creative. I'm also just really excited to have a creative outlet. I am 28 years old. I graduated college in 2016, have been kind of working ever since. The jobs that I've had, although there's been creative aspects to them, they're not creative jobs. And I feel like that kind of part of me has been very suppressed, and I'm just really excited to finally have an outlet to show off the fun ideas that I do have and be able to share all of the books that I'm reading and just be able to put out my passion into the world and be able to connect with people and have those really amazing conversations that I want to have about books. Number four, Why do you love reading? Honestly, I don't really remember a time in my life where I didn't love reading. My mom always read to my brother and I while we were growing up. I have such vivid memories of going to the library every summer, all of our lives. I've always just had a thirst for books and knowledge in general. This question kind of threw me for a loop because I never really stopped to think about it because it's always just been a part of who I am. But I think literacy in general is just the most amazing tool that we have as humans. I always say knowledge is power, and I believe that with all of my heart. And being able to read and communicate allows you to constantly be learning and constantly see and hear new ideas and consume content to make you a better person. I read across all genres. I do really enjoy nonfiction books. I'm, you know, presently reading one about the connection between diet and mental health. I just love being able to be an adult and be out of school, but still have the tools to constantly learn. I also really enjoy reading because it's fun. It's fun to just be able to escape your life for a little bit and experience a different life and experience things that you might not be able to. So books that are fantastical, I don't know about any of you guys, but I don't have any magical powers. So it's cool to be able to read about somebody who has some magical powers, or, you know, especially right now with the state of the world and not really being able to travel. It's cool to be able to read about a character who is living in an environment that I'm not accustomed to and I don't have the opportunity to see right now. I also, and I think more than anything, I love reading because I am in such a love affair with words. I am consistently just blown away by authors' ability to string together these articulate sentences that are so powerful. I think there is nothing stronger in the world than words. You know, words just have the power to change you. They have the power to change the world. And I think that is so incredible. And language is just such a beautiful thing. And I'm very passionate about that, clearly. All of those reasons is why I love reading. Question 5, what book or series got you into reading? Again, I kind of alluded to this. Reading has always just been so ingrained in me that there's not like a series that I have a vivid memory that I started reading. However, I do want to share a story with y'all because I think this book just really impacted me. I graduated college in 2016. However, I finished my English degree in 2015. So the 2015 to 2016 school year, I was finishing my business degree. Yes, I have 2 bachelor's degrees.
Yeah.
From 2015 to 2016, I wasn't really reading a lot of like fun literature. I was reading a lot of kind of boring management articles and books, and some of it was interesting, but you know, it was a lot of schoolwork. And then when I graduated college in 2016, I went straight into work. I worked in retail. I just got really bogged down with life and I just didn't pick up a book. Basically, from when I finished my degree in English in 2015, up until 2018. In 2018, one of my really good friends invited me to go to BookCon with her. And I was super excited because it's something I had wanted to do for a long time. I felt compelled and I felt kind of guilty like going to BookCon, but I hadn't really read anything. And I've heard of these authors, but I haven't read any of their books. I was trying to read a bunch of books. And of course, like I didn't end up finishing anything specific before BookCon. I went there not knowing what to expect. Mind you, BookCon was in New York City at like, I think it's called the Javits Center. It's this huge convention hall. I'm from the middle of nowhere town in Pennsylvania. Like everybody knows everybody. So going from that to New York City, there's just so many people and it's such an exhilarating time. I ended up kind of spur of the moment deciding to go to this panel. It had a few different authors on there. Kristen White, Marisha Pessl. Oh my gosh, I forget her name. Kara Thomas, good grief. And then I think there was someone else and they were talking about, because they all kind of write these suspense mystery books, and they were talking about their writing process and how they came up for their ideas for their books. Marisha Pessl in particular, her story just stuck out to me for whatever reason, and BookCon actually fell. It was like 3 days before her book Neverworld Wake came out. Her describing her writing process to create this book and then hearing what the book was about, I was immediately hooked. I bought my copy of Neverworld Wake because they had finished copies there at BookCon since it was being released in 2 or 3 days. I started reading it there. It took me a little while. It took me maybe like a week or two to finish it because I had been so out of practice with reading, but I absolutely loved every moment of it. And ever since this book, I have just consistently been reading at a very strong pace. And I have fallen head over heels back in love with reading and the whole book world in general. So I attribute this book to getting me out of a essentially 3 year reading slump. I'm definitely going to give my props and my kudos to this book. It's one of my all-time favorite books, one of the most special books to me, and I highly, highly, highly recommend it. Question number 6. What questions would you ask your favorite BookTuber? So hands down, my favorite BookTuber is Books and Lala. I love her. I adore her. I watch all of her videos like the second they come out. Interestingly, I think the first question that comes to mind is how she reads so much. She is definitely a fast reader in general, and I think she has the ability to just get through such a massive amount of books in such a short time. And she works full time and she has a son who I think is like middle school age. You know, she's married and she's caring for a household, and like she continuously just blows me away with this amazing content. However, she just put out a video testing different techniques to see if she could learn to read faster. So I feel like she kind of went over all of that. So I think honestly, there's not like a specific question I have for her. I would love to just sit down and get to hear her story more and just talk with her. I think there can be a lot of inspiration drawn from just conversations with people and, you know, just talking about things you love, at least for me, has always really inspired me. And it's where I get some of my ideas when I do want to write, just talking with people. And I think she's just a really fascinating person. So there's not one question I would ask her. I just want to have a conversation with her. And then question number 7, our last question. What challenges do you think starting a BookTube will be the hardest to overcome? For me, I think the most difficult thing I'm going to face and have to overcome is I like to think of myself as a very open-minded person. I am all about having your own opinions, and as long as you are not being a jerk to someone else or, you know, belittling somebody else's beliefs and opinions, I think you are entirely entitled to what you believe. And I would never push what I believe onto you, but I am all about hearing and learning more about why you believe what you believe. I think the internet can be a very beautiful thing. It can really bring people together, and I think there's amazing platforms for people to share their passions and build a community of shared interests. But I do think the internet has a dark side, and I think that's one of the reasons I've kind of held back, I guess, putting myself on the internet is just all of the hate and the criticism that comes from small-minded people. I'm really hoping that on this channel we can build a community of people that are open-minded and we can all respect one another. And I'm hoping that the hate is not something we will have to face. However, I'm not naive enough to believe that I won't see any hate. And I do think that that will be my biggest challenge to overcome. So I hope you enjoyed this really short video, kind of getting to know me a little bit better. If you would like, I do have a handful of other videos that you can go and check out. I will have the questions listed below if you would like to answer them yourself. I would love to hear why you love reading in the comments. And I hope that you all have a lovely day. Bye. Peace.